When our kids were small, when we used to go home after church on a Sunday, one of the questions when they got into the car, one of the questions we would ask them was, okay, so what did you learn at Sunday school? And one of those Sundays, my second came, Kadesh came into, got into the car very excited, of what he had learned that Sunday. And then so we asked him, okay, so what did you learn? He said, no, I learned that if you obey, honor your parents, in his words, obey, your parents, that I will have long life. And from today onwards, I have decided that I'm going to obey my mama and dada. And my older son, who quickly, jumped in and said, what long life? The way you have been disobedient, you should be dead by now. Those are things, principles that I believe they learn from the time they are in Sunday school. I just want to take you to Luke chapter 2, verse 52. And it says, and Jesus grew in wisdom and stature and in favor with both God and man. I believe that this is a dream or a desire and a wish that all of us parents here have it. We might not voice it out, but in our hearts, we pray and we wish that our children would grow in wisdom and stature, with favor with both God and man. I know that has been my desire, that has been my dream. But dreaming alone doesn't bring about that. There has to be an amount of investment that goes into a child's life from the time he's little. We see that, Jesus at the age of 12, he went into the synagogue in the temple, and he was found there talking to the teachers and, the leaders of the law in the church at that time, in the synagogue at that time. And everybody was amazed at his knowledge and understanding, his wisdom. But I believe very strongly, even though Jesus was God, the Son of God, even though he was divine, he was very much human. And there had to be an investment in his life by both Mary and Joseph from a very early age for him to come to that place of knowing the scriptures. And I think as parents, they put in that responsibility. They took that responsibility seriously. And today I just want to encourage us as parents. Thank you for all those children, or parents of all those children who are on stage. You are doing what is required, because otherwise they would not be on stage. They're part of our Sunday school. You bring them every Sunday to Sunday school and they have been taught the word. But that is not enough in itself. We need, as parents, we have a God-given responsibility to make sure that they are grounded in the word from the time they are little. They say, research says that, from the age of, till the age of 12, from probably about 3 to about 12 years old, that it's a learning stage, where children absorb, they learn things from, the outside world, they learn things, they are in a mindset of a learning mindset, okay, and that is the best time to teach them, and no better time to teach them the Word of God, that they get grounded in the Word of God. But after 12, when they come to their teenage years, it's a time when they need to be convinced of whatever they have learned, whatever they have been taught. And those of you who have teenagers, you know that when they come into teenage years, they have a lot of questions. A lot of, they won't take anything that you say. They will question everything. Now, our family, we have a few debaters in it. And it seemed like, everything was debated about. Everything was questioned. You could not, you had to give them a reason for why you did what you did or said what you said. And we used to tell them, look, this is not your debating practice sessions at home. We need to have discussion. We need to have. So everything was questioned. And parents who have teenagers know that there's a stage of life that everything is questioned. But unless and until they have something to question about, that process is going to be, you're going to kind of run into a difficulty when it comes to questioning. So I want to encourage you, make sure that your children are grounded in the Word. See, wisdom comes not only, wisdom doesn't come with age and maturity. It also comes with what you have learned and deposited in your life. Okay? Like I said before, all of us desire that our children would grow in wisdom and stature. Okay? But wisdom comes from, I believe, that when you invest the Word of God into your child's life, into your hearts, the Holy Spirit, at a point in time when they have questions, when they have a decision-making process that they have to come to, choices that they have to make, the Holy Spirit takes the Word of God and uses those principles to help them make the correct decisions. And therefore, they gain wisdom out of that. Wisdom doesn't just happen. Okay, there is a process involved. And wisdom comes from, you know, that word that has been already in our hearts. The Holy Spirit takes them and helps us to make right decisions based on the principles of the Word of God. And when you get wisdom, when you make right choices in life, when you make, you know, when you live your life according to the Word of God, you gain favor with God. And when you gain favor with God, people around you see that favor. And automatically, or I would say, you know, favor with man also comes as a result of that. So there is some work involved. I'm just going to refer my notes for a little. Yeah, I would also like to take you to 2 Timothy 3:14 and 15. Paul writing to Timothy, about 18 years after he knew Timothy in prison, probably one of his last letters to Timothy, and he writes, he says, but as for you, continue in what you have learned and what you have become convinced of, because you know that those from whom you have learned it, how from infancy you have known the Holy Scriptures, which are able to make you wise for salvation through faith in Christ Jesus. He's encouraging Timothy, who was known the Scriptures from the time he was little, and that taught by his grandmother and his mother, grandmother Louise and his mother Eunice. Now Timothy, now we would say, okay, that might be an ideal situation, but we know, when we really look at Timothy's life and Timothy's family, we know that he didn't come from a very ideal family, like most of our families. None of us, I believe, come from a perfect family. We have our struggles, we have our situations, okay? We have probably some are single parents, some whose parents, the child has both parents, but only one is in the faith. We see Paul writing to Timothy and saying, you know, Timothy's father was an unbelieving Greek, so there was not much input coming from the Scriptures into Timothy's life from his father. It was only the mother and the grandmother from the time he was little that instilled the Scriptures into his heart and life. And Paul writing to him years later and says, but as for you, continuing what you have learned and what you have become convinced of, because you know those from whom you learnt it, how from infancy you have known the Holy Scriptures, which are able to make you wise for salvation through Christ Jesus. And we see here Timothy, you know, Paul encouraging Timothy to, after he has learnt it, he has also become convinced, okay, and now he has become wise unto salvation. So there is a process that happens. So your kids are not just going to grow up one day and be wise. Okay, there is a process, and there is a place that you have to invest in their lives. Now, for those of you who might have done things right, might have taught the Scriptures to your kids, might have grounded in the faith, but sooner or later, when they grow up, they go into your teenagers and their adult life, they might have gone away from the Lord, walked away from Scripture, walked away from the ways of God. And you keep questioning, said, Lord, yeah, I thought I did things right. I thought I did, you know, things perfect. But what happened, you know? Don't lose hope. You know, we see, I just want to use an example of somebody I just spoke to this last week, a mother who I have known for some time. And generally when mothers get together, you know the topic is definitely children. We discuss kids, right? We discuss children. So she was asking me how mine was. And I've known, you know, of course her children are adults now, married. And she was telling me that, we were just talking, and I remember her daughter. She was with us in the youth group, grew up together almost. But because of certain circumstances, got into a very abusive relationship. And I know that there were times when she was battling for her life in the ICU. And as parents, it would have been really, really heartbreaking. And I know so many times we've been called to pray for this girl. And it was so sad. But the parents never gave up hope. They continued to pray. And this mother was sharing. She said it was definitely just prayer that this girl finally came around. And today she's married. You know, she's settled down. And it's definitely prayer. And it was years. It was not just a couple of months or days, but it was years of continuous prayer. And I believe that even when we look at the story of Hannah, she was wanting a child. Because of ridicule, because of situations in her life, she desperately wanted a child, and she kept praying, she kept praying, she kept praying. And then one day God answered her prayer, blessed her with a child. See, sometimes there's a bit of silence when we pray and we pray and pray and God doesn't answer, and then we sort of give up hope sometimes. But like Hannah, like this other lady I was talking to you about, don't give up. Because in time, when God answers, He answers big time. He comes through amazingly. And we see Samuel's life. He was the last judge of Israel and the first prophet. And he really spoke to the nation of Israel and changed things around. He was the voice of God to the nation of Israel at that time. So if you have a situation in your heart and life that you are praying for a child, maybe a young child, maybe an older child, don't lose hope. Just keep praying. Because when God answers, He answers, and He answers well. He gives hope. He brings a different whole perspective to probably your family, you know, your family situation. He will turn things around. But it requires you to, you know, hold on, hold fast, and keep praying. Between Malachi and John, the birth of John the Baptist, there was 400 years of silence. And we see that there was wondering why God was silent suddenly, you know. There was no noise from Him. He was not speaking through the prophets, you know, absolute silence. And there would have been a definite desperation in the nation of Israel at that time. They would have really felt, you know, why isn't God speaking? Why has God let us down? But we see after 400 years, the promise of the Messiah, and the Messiah is born. Okay, and there is hope once again. There is a sense of, you know, and today we celebrate that hope. We celebrate the hope of Jesus. We celebrate that life. And especially this month, even as we celebrate, I just want to speak to parents who have felt that God has been silent in your life. You have prayed and all you see is, I mean, you know, things getting worse and not getting any better. With your children especially. Just don't lose hope. Just keep praying that God will come through. You don't see a light at the end of the tunnel right now. But I believe if you continue praying for your child, if you continue crying out to the Lord, that you will see a light at the end of the tunnel. I just want to maybe just close in prayer. I know my message is short. But I just want to say that I just want us, if there are any parents here, I'm sure there are, to just stand up. And if you have been praying for your children, if you have lost hope, if you are questioning God as to why He hasn't come through for you, if you really need an answer, if you need a turnaround in your children's lives, I just want us to stand this morning. I believe if all of us can stand and just commit, you know, this time, and parents very specially. It's a huge challenge, parenting, and I believe all of us know that. I just want us to stand to our feet. And I'm just going to pray right now, very especially for those of you who need a breakthrough where children are concerned. If we want to have children with favor with both God and man and wisdom, we can cry out to the Lord this morning and ask the Lord, you know, give us that breakthrough. So even as I pray that you on your own would cry out to the Lord and ask for whatever area, name that child. And ask for prayer that child would come through. Let's pray. Lord, we just want to thank you, Jesus, for this morning. Thank you, Lord, for the message we heard by the children so clearly, Lord Jesus. Lord, I pray that even as we have looked at your word and the hope that you give us, Lord, you know, many of us as parents have the desire that our children would grow in wisdom and stature, with both in favor with God and man. Holy Spirit, I just come before you now, Lord, and I know I bring these parents to you, Lord Jesus. Bring our hearts to you. Bring our children to you right now this morning. Lord, I pray that you know the hearts. You know the child, Lord Jesus. You know the parent who is crying, whose heart is bleeding for their children this morning. Lord, I pray, Holy Spirit, that even as you help us to do our part, Lord, I pray that you would intervene and come and change hearts, Lord, of children, Lord Jesus, who have gone away from you, that they would be brought back, Lord Jesus, to your throne room once again. Lord, we thank you, Jesus, because we know that we are going to hear an answer, Lord Jesus, like Hannah did, Lord. Lord, you heard her prayer and you answered her, Lord. And I pray that this child that we are praying for, or children that we are praying for, will come back, Lord Jesus, and walk in your ways, and that they would walk in favor with both God and man. Lord, I pray for the young children, Lord, who are still yet to come to that place of being convinced, Lord, to come to that place of, Lord, questioning your word, Lord. I pray that even as they are nurtured in the word, Lord, as parents, that you would help us, Lord Jesus, with that responsibility. Lord, I pray, Jesus, that these children here, very especially those who are today on stage, Lord, that they would never walk away from you, Lord. Lord, that they would grow in wisdom and stature and with favor with both God and man, Lord Jesus. Lord, I pray for this pair very especially, and I pray for strength for us as parents, Lord, that you would anoint us, Lord, that we might be able to, Lord Jesus, take on the God-given responsibility, Lord, to nurture and bring up our children in the way that they should go, Lord. Lord, we thank you for what you're going to do. We ask in Jesus' precious name. Amen. Bless.